streets of silence through the cold and misty nights. But the more I search, the less I tend to notice. I've been trying to find an answer why you've left me high and dry. Even though you're gonna need a sense of closure. Through all the times you left and said it wouldn't be long, through all the times I waited for you to never come home, I won't back down, I won't back down, I won't back down, so come right back to me. As I gazed out on Manhattan from the peak of Brooklyn Bridge, I could swear I saw an angel.
2 years ago, I was on a hike up to Gothic Basin, where we are right now, and I didn't make it because of a big snowfield, so I decided to camp down the trail. I promised my wife that I would be back in time to cook supper for her on her birthday. 2 days before that, I slipped and broke my leg just about a half a mile from here, maybe 3/4 of a mile from here. And I was there for a couple of days, and I knew I was going to be okay because I had plenty of food, and somebody would eventually come down the trail and I could get help that way. No cell phone coverage at all. And on her birthday, on a Thursday, today's a Thursday, on a Thursday, this guy comes walking up the trail. And I motioned him over, and I asked him this question: do you have any way to contact anyone, because I don't have cell phone coverage? And he said, yes, I'm with Search and Rescue. And I said, what are you doing here so soon? And he said, I was just up on a day hike. And so he called a helicopter, and I got out in time to have supper with my wife on her birthday. So that's how I met Boris. Boris? What's been going on? That was 2 years ago. What's been going on with you in the last couple of years?
Yeah, just a little over 2 years ago. And what Joe here didn't tell is that he is actually a pastor at Restoration Church in McElteel. And since that happened, I've been really thinking about going there, but actually never really did until something else happened too. But I really always thought, right away when that happened, that that was a sign of God and that he had sent me out there on that particular day to find him, because I had made no real plans and just randomly selected that trail to go on hiking. But I'm kind of stubborn too, and I never actually went to his church until
2 years.
Yeah, for 2 years until I met this really beautiful girl. And right after the first time we went out, I knew she was really special. And I witnessed her buy a homeless person a sandwich and something to drink, and from then on I knew she wasn't just like anybody else. And I've been lucky enough to spend a lot of time with her and her family, and they're all Christian, and that really made me realize that I was missing out on something in my life. And I finally decided to go to a Joe's church in McElteel, and I still can't quite believe it, but that day I came on a Sunday was exactly 2 years ago, that day that I had found him on the trail.
2 years to the day he finds me on the trail, he shows up in our church.
Yeah.
That's crazy. That's a God thing.
So that was kind of affirmation for me right away there that I was on the right path. When I was a kid, my grandfather was a preacher. Could talk about God, that he was something like a teacher. He said God only helps those who learn to help themselves. He was a million miles from $1 million, but you can never spend his wealth. I took a little faith and put it in a parking lot. I drove to a strange town full of have and have not. today we're gathered up here in Gothic Basin. But Foggy Lake was just right over this way, which you can't see, but you'll be seeing it in the next video. And I'm here today to take a dunk in the lake. Officially accept Christ into my life.
Yeah.
Did you still want to say something?
No, I was just going to say what you just said. We had a conversation at a coffee house, he said he wanted to go do the next step. So coffee house just didn't seem the right place. So I sent him a Facebook message and with some scriptures, and he looked up the scriptures and a prayer, and he said the prayer, and he responded, said, "I'm ready to do it." And so then we decided to come back here and be baptized in the lake close to where we met.
Yeah, and Jill has been very helpful answering some questions and concerns that I had, and that has actually kept me from going to church for a long time. Officially, long time ago, I did grow up Christian. So I want to thank Jill for that and taking all the time to help me on this journey. And right now we want to take a little bit of time to say a quick prayer.
Yeah. So I want to pray. We're going to pray for Hannah. Boris's friend that has been also very instrumental in him having his heart warmed towards God, and her witness and her family's witness. She's in Russia right now, and she'll be there for a year, and teaching English. Teaching English and finding her way through Russia, so in the culture of Russia. So we want to say a prayer for Hannah. So why don't you bow your heads and join us in this prayer. Jesus, in this beautiful day, in this beautiful creation, we offer this prayer to Hannah, or for Hannah, as she is around the other side of the world, and a new place, a new culture, a new job, people she's never known before. And I pray your blessings on her. I pray your protection on her. I pray that she would feel your presence in her life, and that she would know that she's loved at home. And I rejoice and thank you, Lord, for the influence that she's had on my friend Boris's life, and also her family, for the great witness they are for Boris to make this decision to become a Christ follower, an apprentice of you. And so, Lord, we just ask you to bless her and protect her, keep her safe, and be her comforter in times of loneliness. Give her courage and just lots of favor on her life, Lord. And we trust her to your care. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Boris, have you asked Jesus to come into your life? And will you follow him the rest of your life as best you can?
Yes, I did.
All right. Because of your profession of faith and your commitment to be his apprentice for the rest of your life, it is my privilege to baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grab your nose. Down we go.
Ah, that was cold.
Yeah!
Alright, I just wanted to say big thanks for just a really beautiful day today. First of all, to God for, you know, having this beautiful day today, and then everything that has happened between now and, you know, the last couple months, or maybe I should say last 2 years, really. That's really really cool, and I'm glad we got to go up there today and I got baptized. And I survived it. The water was really cold, but everything went really well. The weather stayed perfect. I just wanted say just a quick thanks to a couple other people too. First to Hannah, and then to her parents, and her dog Billy, and they have all made me feel very welcome. Her dad Don and my mom Karen were really nice, and I got to stay at their bed and breakfast for free for quite a few times. Just want to give them all a big thanks. Without that, I probably wouldn't have been here today, and I wouldn't have felt the same way as I do now. So I just want to say thanks to them. We're gathered here at the fire, and just about to have dinner, so I'd like to say a quick prayer before we start. And I thought it'd be cool to say it in Dutch, which is my native language. And it's my favorite prayer that I'm about to say. It's the one that the apostles asked Jesus what they should say when they prayed, and this is what he told them. But it's kind of the Dutch version of it. Onze Vader die in de hemelen zijt, uw wil geschieden, zowel op aarde als ook in de hemel. Geef ons heden ons dagelijks brood en vergeef ons onze schulden, gelijk ook wij vergeven onze schuldenaren. Maar leid ons niet in de verzoeking, doch verlos ons van het boze. Want van u is het koninkrijk en de heerlijkheid tot in de eeuwigheid. Amen.
Lately I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. But baby, I've been praying hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars.